for all my drivers, young or old, new or fresh, don't matter. If you got in a truck, looking to get a truck, or just thinking about it, period, you know what I'm saying? Haven't even had too much deep thought. Check this out. I want you to think about this for a second. You are the only person that knows your situation, your goals, whether it be financial, your success goals in starting the business. If you already started your business, running your business, keeping your business up, you know, if you want to use old or new equipment, or if you just want to try to see which one to be better. At the end of the day, you should do what is best for yourself. Don't listen to what anybody else says or anybody else's opinion. It's cool to tap into what they're saying just to kind of understand their perspective, but their life is not your life. Their path ain't your path, and everybody's not going to make it in this industry, just like everybody won't make it in any other industry that there is. And the best thing that you can do is fight the fight that you know how to fight and go about however you run your business or do whatever it is that you're trying to do within this industry. Do it how you know how to do it. Like, don't let people influence your mind to be like, oh man, I don't want to get a new truck because this, that, and the third. If that's what you want, if you want to get a new truck because you feel like you don't want to have to worry about like maintenance for a certain amount of time, or if the truck break down, which regardless, anything could happen to the truck, but it's less susceptible if you get a new truck as opposed to getting the old truck. That's just my opinion. I can't speak for everybody else. I'm only telling you how my life is set up. I'm not gonna get a old used truck because it's just like a car. When you get a used car, any vehicle or anything used, period, you 9 times out of 10 have to give that some TLC. And if you're just buying it without knowing whatever the maintenance prior to was done to it, or even if a person is lying to you saying that they did this and that, no matter whether you get it from a dealership or a person, period, you always have that toss up in the air to whether you really gonna get going or not. And then if you don't have certain connections with people, however, you know, people do in groups where they can send you here to get this and that if your truck need parts and this, that, and the third, you still spending X amount of dollars getting an older truck road ready or patching it up so you can run it. And still at the end of the day, you gonna have to continue to do that on down the line as opposed to getting a new truck or a newer truck that has the maintenance records for real, and you know exactly where it came from, all the stuff that's been done to it, if there's anything that has been done to it. You don't have to worry about none of that. And again, like I said, this is my perspective, not nobody else's, but I personally wanted a brand new truck, and I've gotten a brand new truck for my own state of mind and for my own feelings of accomplishments. That's a great accomplishment to me. I have a 2023 Freightliner. When I got it, it only had 1200 miles on it. Let me not say 12,000, 1200 miles on it. And now it has 15,496 as of me speaking on this video recording. I know what's going to happen with this truck. I know when the first oil change is happening. I know when the tires first blew. I know how many hours is on the engine. I know whether I took it through a flood or anything like that, because that's what I choose to do. And I'm going to continue to do that as I build my business more, because I'd rather deal with the headache of knowing I got a new truck and whatever comes with the new truck, as people say all these different things about the technology and stuff like that. None of that matters. All of that kinks and stuff be worked out, just like anything else brand new that comes out. Phones, cars, anything. No matter. Tesla having problems and they're an electric company, which I don't advise that. But anyway, that's a whole nother story and a whole nother topic. At the end of the day, do what you need to do to fulfill the needs of yourself and to sustain the financial stability of your family and whoever it is that you take care of. Don't listen to what nobody else says. Do what you want to do, because you are the person that has to deal with it at the end of the day. Nobody else. And then there'll be people that know stuff, especially the guys that run the older trucks and stuff like that. I'm not discrediting nobody. I'm just, like I said, this is from me, my own person. People know things, and they know what to and what not to look for. And they also know when a person is going to basically stick their foot in their mouth. And a lot of people won't tell you because they'd rather you fail than succeed. But the only person that's going to make you fail is yourself. Now, you can be tricked. Hopefully, you learn from the lesson, but maybe you'll catch this video in time before you do something that you may regret later because you feel like that's a better way. It's not always better just because it's a cash truck or something like that. Again, I say I'm not discrediting nobody, but you have to do what's best for you. And at the end of the day, that's what it's really about. And ain't no other discussion. Can't nobody combat that with me because I'm not in competition with nobody but myself. And all that matters is the decision that I make in my life and what I do for myself moving forward with my family, my children, my wife, and anything like that. But other than that, man, y'all be great, be safe, keep it straight in the lines, and keep the dirty side down.